1985, SPI. This game was made in 1980, and it's a very busy looking map. It's a map of Berlin, so it's no doubt strictly a city and urban arrangement. The reason why I want to play this is it struck my fancy. I was sitting here looking at my full list of, you know, just looking at the boxes of my games and stuff like that, and it struck me that I've been kind of cranking along on this World War II chronological walkthrough thing for several months now, and I really felt like a break, because the next phase will be full-on East Front, and I want to play quite a few titles out of the Eastern Front at a strategic level if I can, and then delve into some operational stuff that will be directly related to the chronological walkthrough. So, I'm sitting here, looking at this game, I pulled the map out, I was like, wow, this is such a great map. It looks so interesting, and it's got the untried counter mechanic, and it's the simple movement rules, simple combat rules. It's a different combat mechanism than typical for an SBI title of this time. It's a points differential based on combat factors versus other things, versus a ratio basis. And the other interesting thing about it is that it is one of the first games that... it's probably not one of the first games. I shouldn't say that. I'll leave that to the grognards who know what they're talking about. But this game has final protective fire in it. It has defensive barrages in it. And it has some air as well. So one of the cool things is that you can add the artillery defensive fire or combat strength to your defense or your offense as part of your combat cycle. And so it's one of the earlier games to do that, I think. That surely is not the first, but I found that to be interesting in the context of this game. The victory conditions are also interesting. There's a... let's see if we can zoom in without making too much of a mess and too much noise over here. Over here somewhere, there is a railroad. See right there? That's a railroad. It runs all the way along there to about there somewhere. Whoa! All the way to there. Now, if the Allies or the NATO forces can interdict that. Oops, excuse me. Yeah, come on, sit still, fella. Awesome camera work, eh? That's why I prefer my phone on the little stand than this large tripod and formal handy cam setup. Nevertheless, so if we can interdict that railroad, we get bonus points and victory points and all sort of good stuff for every turn that we do it. And that road down here, this guy, we get VPs as the NATO player for having control of a hex or interdicting a hex along that highway, that autobahn. Obviously there are victory points for killing things, and there are victory points for controlling various parts of the map, including the two airfields, one of which is there. I'll show you in just a sec. In fact, you can see them two in frame now. There's one here, one here. And there are victory points for acquiring control of those. So that's kind of nice. So what we're going to do, we're just going to kind of crank through this little guy, have some fun with it, see where we get with it. And I think the rules are pretty straightforward. I had a quick skim through them. There are a few little gotchas here and there. I haven't even checked for errata. I'll do that before we get started. And we'll play this and see what we're going to do. Now, the thing I am going to do is, typically I like to play the standard campaign game of anything before I do any other special scenarios. But there's a really cool campaign version here that has the Germans bringing the Bundeswehr in secretly into Berlin as a reinforcing force because they're anticipating the imminent attack of the Soviets. So 1985, Berlin, enemy at the gates, gonna have fun. We'll see how it all works together, and we'll post up some video or pictures in a little while. Ciao.